It's Friday, my dudes.
How's that?
Do that again.
You are so stupid.
That's right.
They're all gonna laugh at you.
That's right.
There is nothing wrong with your radio.
That's right.
This is crazy. What's going on here?
I don't know. It's lousy.
I got $100 smoking in my billfold.
Quack, quack.
I know I ought to save it, but it's burning a hole. Right through my pocket and into my skin. Come on in the morning, I'll be broke again. It's finally Friday, I'm free again. I got my motor running for a wild weekend. It's finally Friday, I'm out of control. Forget the working blues and let the good time roll.
All we want to do is pop you up.
Got a little sugar baby down the road. She's sitting on a radio and rocking on gold. We'll dance up a storm and later on the night. We'll be working on doing all the wrong things right.
That's right.
It's finally Friday, free again. I've got my motor running for a wild weekend. It's finally Friday, I'm out of control. Forget the working blues and let the good time roll.
I'll be back.
Oh, that's wonderful.
You're naked, is that okay?
Uh-huh.
Stop that. You go blind.
It's wet, but it stretches.
It's huge!
Holy poofy fit of hell.
You're in big trouble, mister!
I'll be hurting with my head in a vice. Tuesday, I'll be wondering if I'll ever survive. Wednesday and a Thursday, I'll be slowly tuning in. Friday, I'll be living up my motor up.
Said.
The answer is
Ruthie Fittipaldi.
That's right.
It's Friday.
That's right.
Sounds like somebody's got a case of the Mondays.
Good morning. I'm here. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up.
What is dark matter?
Okay, we don't know.
That's great. That's why it's called dark.
It's exactly.
Everyone knows all reputable information comes from random people on the internet. Tell me things, internet. The earth is flat. It's like school in your hand.
Okay, dark matter is something we do not know what it is. We believe the dark matter is there, but we have never detected it. There is no dark matter out there.
So what one?
There is no dark matter out there. We need to think really hard.
Here's a message of importance to millions of people who are continually pale and washed out.
We just don't.
Happy Friday, my friend.
Jesus, that's the one I wanted. And a happy Friday to all of my friends out there in the interwebs. Happy Friday. This is the IronWorX right here on freeworld.fm. You can also find us over there on the YouTubes. We are back on our main Iron Realm Media channel. So that's good stuff. Good morning, fellas. Happy Friday. How y'all doing?
Happy Friday, my friend.
Not too shabby. Not too shabby. I got some soup
really
last.
People have different days. I've got some Tuesdays going on. They got some Thursdays happening. So I don't know. Y'all are time traveling fuckers, I guess.
I'm the case of the Tuesdays. That's how I buy my Tuesdays. Buy the case.
What that means. I'm trying to understand, Chilster. Healy Wally washed out. I don't know. What's that? Did we just activated a cell?
Nursery rhyme.
Maybe.
He's activated somebody. Yeah. What was that movie? The Captain America one.
Right.
Where they took
Captain America.
Yeah, they took his buddy and brainwashed him. So when he heard a certain group of numbers, it activated him.
Yeah. Yeah, it was the old
Winter Soldier.
Cold War technology, right? Bucky. Yeah, Bucky. That was Bucky. The Winter Soldier.
Didn't he end up in, where's that place called? The one in Africa?
Rwanda. With his electric arm.
Not Rwanda. Rwanda's where the hotel was, where they had that huge fucking massacre of people. You're thinking Wakanda. Of Wakanda. Yeah.
Rwanda.
Hey, Hotel
Rwanda. That was a real bad movie. That's a
totally different movie. Totally different. Yeah, totally different ending. Right.
Oh man. So all kinds of stuff. People are coming out talking about Diddy now. Have you seen this?
I sort of have a little bit. I went down the bridge hole a little further though, so.
Yeah. Some weird, crazy then, old videos from way back in the day.
With his name? Who's that little kid? I forget.
Justin Bieber.
That's the one.
At like 15 years old, sitting there talking about how we can't tell you what we're going to be doing. We're going to be getting crazy.
Justin Bieber over there smiling like he just gave him a hand job.
Yeah. And then he even said, yeah, we're getting crazy. Dude, he's 15 years old. What do you mean you can't tell us what you're going to be doing? Yeah, that was just, I don't know. I'm not making any pre-assumptions. I don't know the guy. People say all kinds of horrible stuff about people.
Yeah. I mean, if you find a hype man and put together a list of all the stuff that he's hyping up, then you find out later that he's a little kid diddler. All that hype stuff may now appear in a different context. Wasn't necessarily the context when it was written because he's still just a marketing guy. Still just marketing.
Yeah.
I can't talk about what we're going to do because, well, we're going to go to the fucking studio and we're going to lay down some tracks. We're going to put this kid in the booth. Exactly. He's going to sing. You know. And we're going to mix all that shit together and we're going to put it out on the record. We're going to sell it to all you dumb fucks. I mean, they could say that, but that's just sort of common knowledge. But to give it hype, you just say, well, I can't talk about what we're going to do.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yep. Don't know the guy. Don't know anything about it. I think it's wild this comes about when all this other stuff's going on. You know?
Of course it does. Distraction.
I was going to say, but has
this one? I tried not to dig down that hole at all. I see things go by and I go, okay, whatever. Since I'm not. And let them direct my attention where they want it to be. I'm going to direct it where I want it to be. Freak.
Did you see that that squatter, professional squatter that was giving people the rules, but the guidelines to, you know, taking over somebody's house and they can't kick you out for blah, blah, blah so long. Well, he got hunted down by ICE and is now, in custody.
Ice tea? I'm so confused right now.
Hot tea. Hot tea and biscuits. Hunted him down. It was a duo. Tag team. It's the next Dog the Bounty Hunter. Put up a TV show on ICE hunting down illegal aliens.
Yeah, Yeah, I guess Florida passed a new anti-squatting professional celebrates Florida's ban as other state laws frustrate homeowners.
See,
yeah,
that makes me nervous. I'm not quite sure why this is one of those things that I remember 15 years ago. It was the thing, squatters' rights and squatting, and you go in and you cut the grass for a year, and ha ha, now you're the one providing upkeep, and now you've got the entitlement, and you've got the vested interest, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I remember thinking it was weird why more people didn't just take advantage of this loophole. But it seemed a strange loophole to have. Not sure why it was there. Squatters' rights. Like something back from the Depression era, maybe. Trying to figure out exactly where squatters' rights would have come from and why they needed to keep them on the books. So again, I'm just wondering what sort of, not necessarily immediate effects, but those far-reaching implications of getting away with squatters' rights, what that's going to do that we just can't see yet.
Yeah, I was wondering that too.
It's like there was a Band-Aid somewhere in the history of this, and that you needed squatters' rights in order to fix it. And it worked. But then it just sort of fell apart, and nobody really saw what it was fixing or what it was doing, and everybody's still just living that American dream, got to go out there and finance your own fucking house.
Yeah, I'm a Chilster. I played baseball growing up, so I probably still have a bat laying around. I'm just saying.
Mm-hmm. 15 illegals coming to live in your house?
Fumigate. Laura says.
Fumigate with gasoline and matches.
Yeah, right. They're saying the big thing is, you know, as long as we can absolutely detail out the difference between squatting being criminal and tenant rights being civil. He says he thinks that will make the difference and give the homeowners the balance and support they deserve. So, yeah. And I think you're right, Josh. This, like all these crazy laws that we have, most of them, like 99% of them, kind of like the opposite of science, right? All these journals that are printing all this nonsense anymore. Well, the laws are like in reverse. They were written for a reason, because something came up and something happened so many times that they're like, oh, we need to make a law about this. This is going on and yada, yada. Yeah. So it could come down to, you know, your right as a tenant, this and that, yada, yada, yada. I don't know if squatters' rights pertain to tenants' rights as well.
I don't think so.
I don't know.
I don't think so, because a tenant implies a contract between a tenant and a landlord. Whereas squatters' rights is none of that. I see Nemo over there on freeworld.fm/chat saying, if I'm not mistaken, it's considered abandoned. If it's considered abandoned, an inhabitant can use it. Maybe you'd probably be hard pressed to consider it abandoned, though. You'd have to go through the tax roll, find the places that nobody's paying taxes on it, because payment of taxes definitely could be considered not abandoned. I don't know. I just don't know. That's right, Billington. Squatters do not equal tenants.
Woman in Flushing was arrested after she attempted to change locks on a $1 million home she inherited when a man inside the abode called police. Oh, so there were squatters in there when she went to go change the locks.
So, Tim Pool is the guy on YouTube. I think he was one of those independent press agents back once upon a time, back when they were starting to throw all this money at independent journalism and these low-level sort of parapolitical reporters. Tim Pool is just a guy. Now he's doing a show, and I mean, it's a relatively popular show.
Oh, yeah.
But I think that there's a, he was mentioning OA, you know, and I think it might have even been something that was, he was reporting on something that had been done. And basically, you just get five or six guys to go up to your squatters and kindly inform them. And we're not calling the police, but you've got 24 hours to get up. And hopefully, sure, even in today's day and age, you can find four or five guys that can say that you've got 24 hours to get out in such a way to impress upon the squatters that they really do have 24 hours to get out. I mean, you can come back with baseball bat. I mean, it's not like you're going to call the cops and you're going to give them the day in court. Like,
yeah,
I'm going to fuck you up every single day until you get out of my house. Period. I don't know. Big shout out. Awesome Lawson clips there. I see you. Awesome Lawson clips. I saw somebody else there. Chris Creek. I see you there in chat too. Try to call out the non-blue people in chat. Let you know we see you. We see you. Sorry to interrupt that. Go ahead.
No, I don't know what I was even saying. Still pouring coffee on the brain.
Yeah.
So, federal judge in Oregon rules in favor of church in key First Amendment lawsuit against city.
Read that one more time.
Yeah, federal judge rules in favor of Oregon church in key First Amendment lawsuit against city. So a church?
The city was, apparently a city took a church to court?
Yeah, that's
Or did the church take the government to court? I'm not sure.
Sure. Either. So a federal judge has stopped a Southern Oregon city's attempt to shut down a church's homeless meal service, ultimately ruling against the city government in a key First Amendment case. Now, I know they were having this issue in Chicago, throwing a lot of the priests and pastors in jail for feeding the homeless. As U.S. Magistrate Judge Mark Clark ruled Wednesday that an ordinance passed by the small city of Brookings on the southern Oregon coast violated the religious freedom rights of St. Timothy's Episcopal Church, which regularly serves meals to the homeless. The ordinance, initially approved by the city in 2021, required a permit to serve free food in residential areas and further limited the church's homeless meal services to 2 days a week. The church, which has served the free meals since 2009, then took legal action and sued the city, saying the ordinance violated its right to freely practice religion. On Wednesday, the federal judge agreed with the church. Mark said the city failed to provide a sufficient reason for restricting the number of days the church can serve free meals. Reverend Bernie Lindley from St. Timothy's Episcopal Church said his church fed people as an expression of religious belief. That's the way we express our faith, by caring for people who are on the margins, especially people who are hungry. We knew that we weren't going to be able to comply with their ordinance. We knew that it was unconstitutional, so we reluctantly filed the lawsuit. To meet the increased demand, they increased meal services to 6 per week, which drew some complaints from residents. The city responded with the ordinance, which would have reeled in the additional services. OK, Okay, while the judge's ruling helps keep the meal service in place, the city and church are fighting other legal battles. So this sounds like it's more than just this. Sounds like somebody at the head of the church and somebody in the city don't like each other. But it sounds like to me. Yeah, the city has also asked the church to stop shower and advocacy services. And the church has appealed these directives. So, freedom of religion. I don't know. I mean, I agree with the judge, but how far does freedom of religion go?
Right. Did Jim Jones have the freedom of religion to serve food to the his homeless parishioners?
Yeah.
Or at least ice cold drinks?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know about this one. Now, the way they went about it, I think the city was dumb. Yeah, well, you can serve them food on these days, but not on these days. That's either they can do it or they can't do it. You know, you can't. Hey, don't be dumb about it. If you're going to try to stop somebody from doing something, you don't give them a, you know, an ultimatum like that. Like, well, you're doing it this many days, but instead you can only do it this many days now. Yeah, it's probably okay not going to win that.
No, I can't imagine. It's okay to feed the homeless 2 days a week, but it is unlawful for you to feed the homeless 3 days.
Yeah, that doesn't make sense. Now, I can understand you saying you're not allowed to feed the homeless because the food isn't checked and this and that and blah, 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 FDA, this and that, and being sued and yada, yada, yada. I mean, you can come up with all kinds of legal reasons why you can't give out food for free.
I can't.
No, I can't either, but,
why you can't sell
wicked
it.
Demon could try. Yeah.
I can see why you can't sell food to somebody else, why you can't start a restaurant business and get a license to do it and then sell food to other people. But ain't no reason you can't just go out there, slap some pork steaks on a grill and put a sign that says free. They can take them.
Well, they started shit like that years ago here. I think we probably have discussed it that, you know, in the local area.
Oh, I think you just got muted there, Walter.
Yeah, I have Cleo up here. Sorry. The city, about 30 minutes from me, has historically had, like, you know, a homeless community. There was, like, these areas between the huge Walmart parking lot that still had, like, tree lines in it between, like, that and the bank or that and the service station or whatever. And they would literally be encamped in those trees. It would be a spot with covering and boxing and place to, you know, grill or have a fire or whatever. And that went on for a while, like to the point that it got, you know, a little uncomfortable being in the Walmart parking lot late at night if you were not accompanied by, you know, someone. A lot of ladies we know here in town stopped going to that Walmart, that kind of thing. So I guess that probably was the impetus for them to begin doing what they did, which was signage at all the major intersections where these people would sit with their signs and wait for help. And there were official city signs on, you know, metal girders and all that. These weren't just thrown up by Joe on a billboard because he's pissed at the homeless people. This was city permit, city signage that said, you know, do not give out these handouts any longer. It is considered illegal. And if you want to help these people, here are some websites. And I'm like, yeah, because they've all got their computers online and there's tents, I'm sure. And that's when it began. And then within the time of that storm we had that went through, where all the people in Texas were being gathered up and the homeless people were saying, hey, they're taking people and disappearing them. And I'm not going, that one dude was just fucking, I am not going with you people. You know, they were literally having to tackle him down to take him out of where he was being rescued from. And about that same time, all the homeless people disappeared in New Iberia. Just saying. Just saying, Chris Creek might be right.
God bless Jeff Gray. He's out there to remind us all that you cannot criminalize asking for help, nor can you criminalize giving help when asked. Down on your luck, grab a sign, stand out there on public property, ask for help. First Amendment protected activity. Supreme Court has already ruled that panhandling is freedom of speech.
There you go, then. How did all that happen? In the presence of free speech, I wonder.
Well, you're only as free as you can defend yourself to be.
Right now.
There's a gentleman, I'm sure you know his name, Josh. He just walks around saying, God bless homeless veterans.
Mr. Jeff Gray.
Yeah. He is great. I love the way he conducts himself when he does his. Would you even call that an audit?
I don't think he considers it an audit.
I don't think so either.
But sort of. I mean, a lot of it is testing local ordinances to make sure that there are, that they're not going to try to enforce anything that would restrict his ability to say, God bless the homeless vet. If you're unsure of what we're talking about, just after this show, give a little search on YouTube's Honor Your Oath Investigation is Jeff's channel name. He does quick videos too. Like 15 minutes is a long Jeff Gray video. Most of them are like 5, 6, 7 minutes because he cuts out all the bullshit. He stands with a sign and he waves. People get mad. He'll put that in there. People come and offer him money that he doesn't take, but they'll offer. He'll put that in there. And then, of course, when the cops come to try to kick him off public property, he definitely puts that in.
I love when he starts telling them, well, then I will panhandle. There's nothing you can do about it.
You can't panhandle. Sir, can I have some money? Can I have $20? It's there. I just panhandled. I just asked you for money. I just
panhandled. Rest me. Yep. That's great.
Well, as we're quickly approaching this first break,
exactly.
Oh, sorry. I have a helper. She's moved on. That was her exit. That was her exit mute. She was out. One more time. Anyway, I dropped a song I want to hear from a new band I found over the last day or so called True North. Really great band. I think you guys will dig. And then I dropped a song there for Nemo and for Chris in chat there. And then, like I said, Alex Michael has dropped a new song from him and Steve Falconer, which is a fucking great song if you haven't heard it yet. So that's three songs there, and I know you guys have stuff you want to hear. So maybe we do double songs for the breaks. That gives you a little more time to prep for your, can you do that, though? Is that something you can do without sitting on the board? I don't know.
Oh, yeah. I imagine so.
Okay. Just a suggestion.
Action's crafty.
I know he's the shit. Smell him?
I'm not very talented, but I'm fucking crafty. I'm crafty.
And I saw Alex Michael in the chat way early when we started off, but I haven't really seen much from him since then. So I hope you're still around, brother. We definitely want to hear that. And we'll be playing it at some point. And we need to get you back in here, man. It's been too long. I think your debut of your new record was the last time we had. Hell, we were on our old channel. I mean, this channel, I think, the last time we had you here. And that was centuries ago. So, that being said, this afternoon, we have a guest already lined up. I'm excited to catch up with Brendan Daly.
That's right.
And then Next Friday, we'll be talking to our buddy Horry Sheet, who I need to get on with this weekend and do a little test call. He has a new account there on Skype and stuff, so I'm going to do that with him. And who else? You don't know. You never know who we'll pull out of our realm.
Good. All right. It is that time. I suppose we can just go ahead and take a little break. We can certainly try. Although I... Nope.
Maybe not.
No, we can do it. I just got to find the right line so that when I press play, it'll actually come out. You know how we do here on the IronWorX.
I do know how we do.
Make sure you guys stick around and you continue to know how we do on the other side. Off my chest, cut the anchor from my ankle. Quit letting out the rope.
'Cause I'm stained by your disdain. I am rankled by your rancor. Running out of hope. All the birds and all the bees, the girls who fly the high trapeze, tumble to the ground without a net. And all of our advanced degrees and all our sweet discoveries could save us, but they haven't saved us yet. I once believed in extraordinary grace. Put my faith in saints and saviors. In the mirror I can't bear to see my heroine killing time till time returns the favor. Killing time till time returns the favor. Take your tactical defense. Take your silent petulance, your temper's coiled in spring. 'Cause I no longer find exciting this pendulum we're riding when moods start to swing. All the moms and all the pops, convenience stores and auto shops cannot fix the promises we've broken. All impassioned pleas to Jesus, all the phony press releases, falling short of truths we've never spoken. I once believed in extraordinary grace. Put my faith in saints and saviors. In the mirror I can't bear to see my heroine. Killing time till time returns the favor. Killing time till time returns the favor. Killing time till time returns the favor. In the mirror I can't bear to see my heroine. Killing time till time returns a favor. Killing time till time returns a favor. Take this anvil off my chest. cut the anchor from my ankle, quit letting out the rope.
You don't like worrying about things that are bigger than you. While your husband and children are sent off to war, you hang up your flag, miss, don't ask much more. You think your side is winning, but you don't know the score. They're on peace in the East, we are the best in the West. We don't reason very well wearing bulletproof vests. It ain't money that's power, it's knowledge that's king. Better open your eyes, sir, they ain't the same thing. You don't have either, and that's why you're down. That ain't never gonna change while your head's in the ground. They don't want you going anywhere except 6 feet underground. I believe in those dog-lying wolves on the screen, whose words you believe in, whose pockets are green. While you're green with envy, you guess it's okay, long as everybody else is getting stepped on the same way. You think you have freedom, but you'll wake up someday. So they tax you and drug you and work you to death. They defeat you and cheat you until your last breath. Then they poison your body and waste all your time. Then they pull on your strings, but it's all in your mind. You think you make choices, but you're just last in line. Churching you, schooling you, ruling you through, selling you, telling you what's good for you to do. They abuse you, confuse you, and use you each day. Then they paralyze you, sterilize you, that's how they play. And you trust them, you lust them, you do anything they say. And they make you their pet, cause you signed your name away. Think you have freedom, but you'll wake up someday, but still you play. Yes, you think you have freedom, but you'll wake up someday. There's just no way. You think you have freedom, but you'll wake up someday.
And welcome back. Second half of the first half of the IRONWORX right here at freeworld.fm.
If you work in IT.
No, shut up. There we go.
Man, that's a great, great song. Yes, every time I hear it.
It really is.
Hey, who is the other artist with Alex?
That's Steve Faulkner. Space Busters.
And he's got a great voice. Their voices blend well together.
Yeah.
Really, really well. Right before that, we heard a song called, good Lord, sorry, Extraordinary Grace by a band called True North, the lead singer there, Christian Granger. And the guy on guitar and fiddle and all that, damn it, his name is gone and I don't have it open anymore. Anyway, he built all that you heard, like every instrument you heard him playing, he hand built himself. He's got extraordinary large mitts, he says, and nothing he could play was right for him. So he started making these instruments. If I'm not mistaken, she is a craftsman as well. I'll have to go look it up again. Anyway, that's how I found him, is in a guitar article about his guitars and how just different they are. And I started digging in, and man, I haven't heard a song I don't like by them yet.
Just killing time until time returns the favor. What a line.
Right, that shit hit hard. Definitely.
Yeah, very well done. Love it. What is the Comstock Act? Have you heard of this before?
Sounds vaguely familiar, but I did also just watch a podcast with a fellow named Dale Comstock not too terribly long
ago. I don't know. That does sound familiar to me. What's the concept there?
So this is from The Hill. It says, fears grow over Comstock Act, Justices Thomas and Alito. Oh, abortion rights supporter. Yeah. From a lot of enforced nationwide abortion ban, blah, 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 blah. Okay, I'm not even going to get into that. Okay. Yeah, people are learning that these solar panels are great until Mother Nature throws a hailstorm at you.
Yeah. Well, which, I don't know. I mean, it looked to me like it wasn't a natural occurrence. If you're talking about that thing that just happened.
Yeah, there's a massive solar farm in Texas. And yeah, exactly. Hail crippled it. It's saying it's running at reduced capacity as a result of the storm. Southeastern Texas. And it just destroyed large portions of a massive solar farm. Just highlighting the perils of trading traditional power sources for vulnerable green alternatives. Yeah, and the potential for chemical leaks from the broken panels. Yeah, that's the thing. A lot of this green energy stuff, but the stuff that inside isn't very green. You know, it's very toxic to the environment. Well, toxic to humans. Cadmium telluride is the big one that humans shouldn't be around. My concern is the hail damage that came through and busted these panels. We now have some highly toxic chemicals that could be potentially leaking into our water tables. That's what one of the residents was saying. Saying that all the residents around here have children in the area who are all on well water. And they're concerned that, you know, all this, these chemicals from these things are leaking into their water tables. Yeah, that's a serious concern. Go to places like Flint and talk to the people there about their water. Yeah, and they're saying, okay, as far as solar farms being damaged where hail and tornadoes are common, those companies knowingly run the risk of building solar panel farms in these areas. Yeah, it says events like this underscore the importance of having an all-of-the-above energy approach to meet our energy needs. And showcase how our country cannot solely rely on or fully transition to renewable energy sources like this.
I don't know. That'd make a lot of sense to me. Isn't that the point of fucking capitalism? Like, what are we building to last? And why are we now pointing our finger at solar panels saying, no, no, you should be made to last.
Yeah.
Why? I mean, from a consumer point of view, I can see why it's horseshit. But as an entrepreneurial point of view, what is wrong with building solar panels that are sensitive to hail. Oh, yeah, you gotta replace them. Sorry, I guess you gotta buy some more. Yeah, that's the fucking point.
Just real quick, like, wouldn't there be a cleanup crew? It's not like they're gonna just be leaving stuff to just be absorbed into the ground.
You'd be surprised. I mean, they sell them fucking little halogen screw-in light bulbs that are toxic as all fuck to the entire environment that you're supposed to dispose of properly and not just chuck in the trash, and they expect all of the entire population of the world to go to pay to have them properly disposed of, but nobody does. They just chuck them in the trash to be absorbed into the ground. I mean, they could probably, I'm sure they hire a cleanup crew, but fuck it, what do they, now you gotta have somebody call and report it. Pay them to have them come out and clean it up. I'm sure they would. Cleanup crew's not going to be free.
Just make sure you don't spill any fluoride on top of it.
I've got this other issue. Like,
oh,
well, you go outside and you breathe the air. The air is pretty fucking big, right? There's a lot of it. Like, you go up in the air, there's a lot of air up there, too. So I'm trying to figure out what the fuck happens when you boil vinegar. Like, I saw Travis start one, a big old pot of vinegar, yeah. Cloudy as fuck. I'm like, okay, good, this is Travis. Yeah. I'm going to come back for part two, and Travis is going to be like, all right, well, I've been boiling vinegar for like 3 hours, and it's still fucking cloudy. Yeah,
that's harder.
And there's part two, and it's a blue fucking sky.
Yeah, but then afterwards, like an hour later, it was cloudy again.
While you were still boiling?
Yeah.
Good. That makes me feel better.
Yeah, it was just rolling in just like a normal day would have. It would have just had oscillating clarity and clouds, clarity and clouds. So I feel like doing it again, especially because I'm going to Texas for the eclipse. So I feel like trying to do it a couple of days ahead of time as well, just to see if it's not just like an immediate thing. Because I think that, who was it that I said that I saw somebody said that there? Oh, it was Crow. He said he was going to like boil vinegar for 2 days ahead of time, and I was like, oh, that might make sense. Like, it has to be up there and sit for a while.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, what happens if you do it when it's raining? Will it stop raining? Will it get rid of those clouds, or are rain clouds too heavy? Like, I don't know. Didn't make any sense. But I don't... Crow is not one of those people that I consider sort of blowing with the wind. It's not like he says, ooh, this boiling vinegar trend is going to be cool.
Right. That's the only thing about this that makes me even consider it, is that person's approach to it. No offense at all, Travis. I know you're a smart man as well. I'm just saying, Crow keeps thinking it works. I haven't tried it, so I can't say one way or the other. I do know vinegar is a great thing inside your body. I know that. I know it's great for, like, if you have smells, you know, in your house, and you have it, boil it, or even have it like warm next to the heater or the stove or whatever, and that helps get those smells out. And if you wash things with it, that helps to get those odors out. I don't know.
Yeah, you know, the thing that I was thinking was that it doesn't have to do with natural clouds. I don't think it has to do with natural clouds. I think the issue was having to do with geoengineering aspects of it. That's what I understood.
Well, far be it from me to be a fearmonger. Oh, I can't read the story anyway, so I don't want to read it. I'm not going to talk about something I can't read. No, I'm not going to. I can't read it. It's got a pay window. I'm not going to get into something that I don't know the details on of this nature. Sorry. Move on.
Very, very far be it. It'd be very far.
Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. morning.
What's up, Andrew? Or,
what's up, Andrew? Wherever Andrew, you guys happen to be located on our great plane. If anyone's wanting to do that, there's a fairly inexpensive way to boil vinegar. And you just go down to your local, like, camping store and get yourself a Coleman propane canister. I think there's like a 1 liter or something like that that will burn for a very, very long time. And a little bit of a, in that same area in your camping, they're going to sell the stuff for camping, for a propane type of a torch. And then you just put a pot over that with some vinegar in it and boil it. And it'll boil for several hours.
You could probably just make a fire, too.
Well, yeah, you can do that, too.
So you have to do it outdoors? That was my next question. Actually, I was going to get to that. Is this something you have to do indoors?
Yeah, apparently Alex Michael, Amanda Vollmer, and Crow have all done it, and they all say it works.
Okay. So there's a thing called cloud busting.
I've done it.
And I've been doing it. I've been doing it for years.
But yeah, like Josh was more just asking, that. Like, if it's raining, will I get rid of the rain? I would hope not.
Well, I think this more has to do with our abilities that we're so suppressed and are so removed from our daily existence that we don't even know we have anymore, that you are by proxy of doing this ritual of boiling the vinegar. It's basically just like doing a smudge ceremony or a, you know, you're sitting down with intent and there you go, right there with the intent. You've already started a fucking magical process in motion that if you have enough of a personal energy base and, you know, centeredness and all that, you can achieve amazing magical shit in this realm. I don't really think that, I don't know where the vinegar attachment got to it, except for maybe what I had just read there about the fact that in Chinese folklore, it's considered that boiling vinegar will kill certain things. Viral things.
Okay, well, then what about
things?
When it comes to intention, what about how, like, people that did rain dances, like, you know, Native Americans that did rain dances? Right.
That's what I'm talking about, is the intent is what is all intent and the flow of energy, the redirection of energy. Now, does that vinegar boiling and rising up to the atmosphere carry that intent up? I don't doubt it. Energy does have a medium that needs to move through it sometimes. I mean, it's the idea of, the smudge ceremony. You know, I'm blowing smoke on your person, but that's not all I'm doing. I'm blowing energy into your energy field. I'm blowing my intent into your intent. I'm blowing intent. I mean, that to me is where it all comes from, but that's just me. I haven't done it.
All right.
I do know I've done the cloud busting. So go ahead, Travis.
That's okay. Let's just kind of brainstorm about this because, you know, like, well, what did Amanda do different than me? Like, what did Alex do? Like, so I just boiled vinegar. You know what I mean? Like, what are the other variables that I didn't do that they did where they got success? I don't know. The one thing I saw a lot of the times was, and you know this from camping, that the wind blows the evaporation, you know, in various directions. You know, one way it's blowing east, it's blowing west, it's blowing south, it's blowing north, all within the, you know, 3 hours. So basically, it's just distributing it in all the cardinal directions. You know what I mean? So my question, what I was thinking was, I don't know what else to do. I mean, I just boiled vinegar for 3 hours. Like, what else am I supposed to do to have this working?
Wish I knew.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know.
I remember years and years ago, I even saw in chat, Organite cloud busting was a thing. There were guys like building large contraptions with buckets of like Organite, and they were like directing their orgone energy into the sky and like clearing out clouds. But maybe it was like the vinegar, maybe it was just clouds coming in. But he was like doing it during a lightning storm. It was, I saw some crazy stuff with some of these.
Yeah, I remember all that too. Yeah. And they were also putting them out by towers.
I remember that too. they're like, you could just like email them and they would send you a little puck of organite. And you could just go and start dropping it around. They were doing that shit for free. They would send it to you. Once upon a time.
Pontius was doing stuff like that. He was making organite pyramids.
I wanted to get into that at one point when I discovered it and got to looking into the process and realized it would probably be something that I would gather a lot of materials for and never get completed. Just that tends to be my trajectory on stuff that's that involved.
Yep.
I miss that totally.
I think that was just an open mic, a little bit of a hot mic going on.
Yeah, let's mute him up if that's what that was. Sorry.
Yeah, I think that's you, Trev.
Okay, I'll mute.
Real quick, shout out. That's fine, brother. Shout out to Jack streaming there in chat. Oh yeah, definitely. I'm so sorry for your loss. Definitely. Spot was only three. He was way too young. So nothing. I love an eccentric cat. In fact, right now I've got one that just got up and walked away. I was going to put on camera, but she's very eccentric. Is Ripley. She's very, she's just something different. There's something different about her mannerisms and the way she interacts with us. And yeah, eccentric's a good word for her. Not nuts or crazy, because I've had the crazy cats too, or been around the people who had the crazy cats that, you know, are literally psychotic. But yeah. Definitely sending lots of love your way.
I don't know if you guys know this or not, but Brian, CB, and I are, friends. We just were at a meetup this last weekend, and one of the guys that comes to the meetup, sometimes he'll bring his organite pyramids, and he makes little pucks and all kinds of different things with his organite that he does. So I've got I sent you guys a picture of my dashboard. I've got my pyramid on my dashboard.
Oh, shit. Let me go look. Yeah. Awesome. I've got one sitting right here in front of me here. I'll put it on camera. It's a tiny one. Michelle got me not long ago. It's a little baby one.
It is a little baby one.
But it sits right in front of me on my, right under my monitor.
Hey, so if I can ask us to maybe discuss the different, I saw the different patterns on a graphic of the eclipses in the past years. And to me, it struck me as interesting because they were going in various crisscross patterns, right? How do we understand that in terms of the path of the sun? Because the way that I was thinking about it, if I were still in the heliocentric model, I would think that we would have had to have changed a very crucial direction in order to get a crisscross pattern of the sun's path across the United States or wherever it's going to be. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Absolutely. To go from that seemingly stable path, according to what they're telling us, to creating this gigantic A across the United States, seems like there would have had to have been some serious dog legs made somewhere.
Right. Yeah. Right. So like my question is, okay, so since I'm thinking about this for the first time, is it out there in science somewhere where they have talked about it and we just, you know, don't know what the discussion is or what they would say? Because if these eclipses, right, do happen on a globe Earth, then how the hell do you account for the fact that it's going in a completely different direction, which would mean that the planet would have to have been, you know, altered in some way in terms of its path, unless they already account for it? That's what I'm asking for. Do they already account for it and it's just wrapped up in their whole bullshit anyway?
Seems like it's probably wrapped up in their bullshit already. It seems like we wouldn't be the first people asking this question in 2024. But
yeah, when they find the eclipses, they don't use like the heliocentric model to then figure out when the next eclipse is going to take place.
Nope, they call for it.
Yeah, they call
it. Yeah, I know, I get that. Yeah, yeah. I mean, I get that part for sure, but they still have to account for it, or they just go, oh, yeah, don't pay attention to all that stuff over here. Just look over here at the new nebula we found.
Yeah, not even future eclipses. That's just talking about past. Let's talk about the last three. I mean, how do you account for those vastly different, almost completely different? Like, how do you get an X? If you're going one direction, you've got to completely make two dog legs to, like, draw an X on a piece of paper.
How is one 75 miles and the other 125 miles wide? That's a huge difference. I don't know.
I don't know nothing about nothing.
All right. Well, that's just something that I was thinking about recently. So if it makes sense to you that that's a question, then okay, I'm good with that as long as it's a reasonable question.
Seems like it.
All right, I got it. I found the explanation. Here we go. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
There it is. I've got out diagrams.
Hold on. Let me pull you up.
Oh, he's got the diagrams.
Yeah, you just hit,
what is it, 18 years and so many days, and you just hit reset, and they all
had, they had a big X over an area of Africa. It looks like this is a badly done graph. It didn't size up when I made a bigger picture. Sorry, but we get the idea, I suppose. So, and then here is the newer layout showing the X across Texas. And over here, the X, and here's an X. There's an X. So, yeah. I'm guessing a 23 degree tilt followed by a dark matter wibble glip. Probably that's a word they would use, I would guess. And then, I mean, they can make shit up. I can make shit up, right?
Absolutely. All right. Well, we've hit the top of the hour. I've got this song. Well, you'll probably recognize it. This is, again, it's a cover song, but it's somebody else covering some Don Williams music.
Oh, nice.
It's Chris Stapleton covering Don Williams. I'm pretty sure this was a Don Williams original, because I've heard it covered a few times, but I'm pretty sure it was Don's original version, I think. I think this is actually Chris and his wife, Morgan, perhaps. But here's a little song just called Amanda.
I've held it all in. God knows I've tried. It's an awful way in country boy's life. The hair on my shoulder and the age in my eyes. Amanda, light of my life. Fate should have made you a gentleman's wife.
Still wearing jeans. Amanda,
What is dark matter?
Okay, we don't know.
That's great. That's why it's called dark.
It's exactly.
Where everyone knows all reputable information comes from random people on the internet. Tell me things, internet.
The earth is flat.
It's like school.
Dark matter is something we do not know what it is. We believe the dark matter is there, but we have never detected it.
Well, what I'm afraid of course, is that there is no dark matter out there.
There was one?
There is no dark matter out there. We need to think really hard.
Happy Friday, man.
Think really hard.
Not to worry. I have a permit.
This just says I can do what I want.
Yep. Welcome back. First half of the second half of the IRONWORX kicking off right now. You can find us each and every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday morning over on freeworld.fm, where we've got the good chat.
The good chat.
The good chat.
Yeah, I see people asking about that last song in chat. That was a band called Jimmy's Chicken Shack from an album called Pushing the Salmonella Envelope. Great album, start to finish. And our buddy Nemo dropped the lyrics earlier for Chris, so I was just blown away. I didn't know anybody else.
Have you guys heard like the song that Alex Michael just put out with Steve?
We played it on our first break, sir. Yes, we did.
Oh, shoot.
Alex is actually in chat. No, it's fine, brother. It's actually
an
amazing tune. Yeah, he was.
That's an amazing song. I mean,
great song. Yeah.
Huge shout out to that song. I listened to it like 5 times in a row.
Yeah, I did too. Yeah.
Yeah, that's one every time you hear it, the words tell you something, you hear something new.
Yeah, I didn't
Alex was saying in chat like that Steve, well, not only can Steve sing and play, obviously, he wrote the song, Steve did. Yeah, Alex was saying that in chat earlier. He wrote the lyrics, and yeah, Michael helped him, you know, flesh out, I'm sure, the harmonies and stuff. But yeah, that's, yeah, great stuff, man. We need to get Steve over here. Have we ever had him, like, just him over here back in the day? I don't know if we have, man. I know he's been around, you know, the group. We probably had him in a off the air talk or something, but yeah, I don't think we've had him in over here. We need to do that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And he hangs out with the best people, so.
Yeah, Steve's like one of those guys, kind of like Alex, where you could just probably just hang out with him every single day.
Yeah.
Not get bored.
I definitely get that vibe. Yep, definitely do.
Yeah, Steve is one of those, whenever we had him on Glowbusters, we'd have, like, you know, the conversation before the show that should have been recorded.
That should have been the show, right? Yeah,
that's like the vibe. Every time, he brings stuff that he's like, hey, can't really talk about this yet, but listen to this. It's like, oh, my goodness. Yeah. And then, of course, he comes out and makes the videos and all that stuff. But, yeah, just a plethora of knowledge, we'll say. Yeah, that guy is genius.
Yeah, I would say anyone that's had their YouTube channel shut down multiple times probably has some good information to tell you.
Yeah. Yeah, and that he
kind of weird to say that, right?
They've definitely shut him down multiple times.
Hey, just real quick, I remembered a thought that I had the other day when I was thinking about the double sun thing. So it's been captured by Chris and Crow both, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
And they were using a solar filter like we normally use to capture the sun.
They were using a double stack hydrogen alpha filter. It is a solar filter, but it's not like the kind we use.
Right. So that's what I was going to ask because I was trying to remember the details. Okay. So then the thing that I was thinking was that if you were looking through whatever it is, your Celestron or whatever, and you're using the double stack solar filter and you see the two suns, I was trying to figure out like why you couldn't see the second one with your eyes as well. And then I couldn't remember what the details were. So then what's the explanation in terms of what the double stack has with its setup as, you know, I don't know what it's polarization or whatever, so that they, it allows you to see the light of the second sun. Is that what we're,
you're looking at a different spectrum of light.
I think
that's what it is.
Is it the hydrogen gas that refracts the light or whatever?
Yeah. There's
something about it. I remember vaguely.
Something with looking through the gas does something to it.
Do they make a single stack hydrogen alpha filter?
I do not know.
And if they did, would you still catch a second sun? Because I'm thinking, I hear two suns, and then I hear double stack, and that just suddenly, for some reason, threw a flag up in my brain that, for some reason, wasn't triggered before. Or if you had a triple stack hydrogen alpha filter, would you see three suns?
I don't think so.
Well, here's the problem with all those theories. There have been people who've caught these things with regular cameras at regular sunsets. I think it's more of a time of year thing from stuff I've seen.
Well, right. Okay. So if you can capture it with regular cameras, are you saying that they don't use any filters at all?
I've seen, like, early on when we were first talking with Crow and Chris during that same, like, when it was happening, literally in the driveway over there at Bob and them's house, there was a gentleman out of Florida, Donnie from Daytona, and he was out walking his dog and just picked his camera up towards the sky, and there was clouds moving in front of the sun, and there was another sun. And then there was another, so he caught like three or four. I can't remember how many it was, but it was the most insane footage at the time that we'd ever seen. And he literally was just walking his dog and caught it with a phone. Then there were, at that time of the, we had all the wildfires coming out of Canada and up north and stuff. There were a lot of people catching double sunsets during that time frame. And I mean, Cami and, you know, over there at the house, they had kind of figured out it had something to do with the polarization of those filterings. So add the smoke at a certain time of the year. I don't know. It just seems like that's kind of part of this to me anyway.
So then what if we have dozens of suns? Let's go back to the crisscross pattern.
Remember back in like leading up to the 2017 eclipse, everybody was talking about, and there was footage out there of a guy on a plane to see the eclipse, but he wasn't one of the guys with the official cameras pointed out the windows on the mounts and all that shit. He was just a dude walking through the cabin with his camera, recording what everybody else was doing in the cabin. And as the eclipse began, he put his camera over somebody's shoulder, and on their fucking camera feed they were seeing crazy shit. So he put his camera to the window and caught the same crazy shit, which was, as the sun was being eclipsed, these little clear globular fucking crystal ball looking things, almost in the shape of the Big Dipper constellation, appeared right next to the sun. And somebody else after that took that footage and like broke it down, dude, in a way you can't even conceive of. They took like scratches on the window and showed how they moved in relation to the movement of the aircraft. But these little circles in the fucking sky were dead stationary still next to the sun. They were no doubt outside that window. They weren't part of the window and all this shit. So at that time, you know, I was kind of convinced there were multiple suns up there. And as they change their whatever, their frequency, their emission, their time, their whatever, that's what the eclipses are, is them switching out the sun.
Now, you guys, you remember me bringing up that NASA scientist from the 90s? I've been looking for the article forever. It's wiped from the internet. But the NASA scientist from the 90s who is studying the sun in Antarctica went crazy and started telling people the Earth had three suns. You guys remember this at all? I mentioned it like maybe a handful of times over the last decade. but it's an article I've been looking for forever, but it's been scrubbed from the internet. You can't find it anywhere. But yeah, a NASA scientist that came out saying that the Earth had three suns. And then he was, you know, considered crazy and blackballed and all that kind of good stuff. So it's been said before, for sure. I wish we could talk to that guy. No, it doesn't ring a bell at all.
I'm not offhand right away. Uh-oh, hang on a second. What are you doing, girl?
Wow, I do remember you talking about it before, but I don't know anything beyond what you know. So
yeah, no, I've never been able to find anything about it. I just remember it. It was one of those, because, you know, I was always a NASA fanboy. And I was like, oh, man, well, what did this guy see that drove him insane? You know, that was my thought at the time.
Or I had to do this. I know. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Good. Well, I was, you know, trying to grab that footage I was talking about of the three or four suns from Donnie of Daytona. Currently, I can't find Donnie's channel, but I have about 7, 10, 15, about 15 to 25 videos trying to debunk the stuff that he's apparently filmed, because he's also caught UFOs, he's caught stuff on the sun. And so I see all of these videos that are like, just like flat earth debunk videos, very stupid looking, people with tinfoil hats on, some guys wearing a top hat with a mask and glasses. And yeah, it looks like the usual paid trolls showing up to debunk good shit. So that really makes me want to find this footage even more. I'm just blown away that it's not here. His channel's not here, but there are constant, like every third one is somebody trying to show how idiotic this gentleman Donnie is while he's sitting there in a fucking top hat and a pair of welding goggles, because, you know, he's cool. Oh my god. Anyway, sorry, go back to your thing. That blew me away that I can't find it.
That old saying, if it's on the internet, it's in there. It's out there, you know. I don't know about that. I mean, they can scrub all kinds of stuff they don't want people to see. How easy do you think it is now with the AI searching the internet? I think they could just type in a name or something like that and hit a button, and within 10 minutes, everything on the internet with that name is gone.
It'd be hard. Once upon a time, say, I don't know, 6 or 7 years ago, something like that, in an attempt to throw off Mark Zuckerberg, I went through and made friends on Facebook with like 7 other Joshua Coreys. Because fuck him. So there's that. It'd be hard if you want to say, well, I'm just going to scrub all Joshua Ryan Coreys. Because again, I think I was even that specific. And I think you'd scrub more than just me off of there.
Yeah, there's got to be a way. I'm sure they have us all, you know, categorized.
Tags.
Yeah.
Just find the Joshua Ryan Corey with the flat earth tag associated with it.
This one can see. Here then, Josh. Do. I was looking at this article. There's an iPhone, YouTube, and the First Amendment. Man in St. Louis tests boundaries of Constitution through videos. I thought about you as soon as I heard this, Josh.
It wasn't me.
I gotta see this. No, it definitely was.
Although I'd be interested to hear.
Yeah.
Because I don't know that I've heard anything from St. Louis. There's been some stuff from Southwest Missouri. Been some stuff out of KC, Kansas City. There's been a few things, but not a whole lot from this side, St. Louis area. I've seen a couple, but not many.
What says with his iPhone and tripod in hand, a man that only goes by the name Good Citizen is going into public places with a goal of documenting public encounters. He's what's known as a First Amendment auditor, often provoking confrontations with police and security guards. Oh, geez.
Yeah,
with his stated goal of alerting the public and government employees on the First Amendment.
Don't exist. Just don't exist. Your existence is a provocation, you son of a bitch.
And there's no provoking. I've watched... Now, there are a couple people that are assholes once, you know... Once you speak to them out of turn, or not even out of turn, just with that attitude, they go, you know, all guns blazing... Fire everything all at once, all torpedoes, you know, go. There are those First Amendment auditors. But for the most part, most of them aren't like that.
I think it's a time and place situation. Are you keeping up with James Freeman and what he's been doing lately?
I just watched one he did yesterday where he was at the town meeting.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
But he's there with other auditors. They're like in the RV and they're traveling around and... There's like,
yeah.
He's not just there by himself. And I think now they're up on like in the Northeast, but they're, I think, going around in an attempt to provoke a little bit. I think they have a list of places that need some provocation. And I get the impression that's what they're doing, is driving around and making sure that provocation is met with silence. Like, you can provoke cops all day long. There's nothing wrong. There's nothing illegal with provoking cops. Yell at cops. Scream at cops. Call them names. Do whatever you fucking... I mean, you can't hit them. But if... There was a motto I lived for a while that says... If you're easily offended, you should be offended, or something like that. Or I love offending people that are easily offended, something to that effect. And I think if you are easily provoked, then you should be provoked. People should be out there provoking you in an attempt to get you to do something. Because if you react, then fuck it, you're gone. And if you don't react, well, then more power to you. That's what practice is for. You're welcome. But if you're that easily provoked, you shouldn't be working for the public. You shouldn't be in the government. You shouldn't be working in for someone who has a monopoly on violence. If you're easily provoked. Tyrant Finder is a good banner. That is good banner. Tyrant Finder. Tyrant Detective.
Yeah, there's a guy, NC Tyrant Hunter. He loves his First Amendment right.
He's one of those really good mirrors, too, where he will give what he gets.
Yes. As soon as you, you know, start throwing a little sass his way, he throws it back tenfold.
Uh-huh.
All right, if you want to be like that, we can be like that. He is, no problem. Telling people off. Doesn't matter how old you are, man, woman. Yeah. No problem. But if you're nice, one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet. Got that southern twang in his voice. Just seems like a really nice, nice guy. You know, treat him with respect. He'll treat you with respect. Give him a little lip. You're going to get some lip. probably a lot more than you were given too. Yeah, big shout out MC Tyrant Hunter. Bam. If you know, you know. And that brings us up to our last break here, gents.
It surely do.
It does indeed. Wow.
It done did it, folks.
Well, just before we go, I did finally see one person that had a video, the best footage, best UFO footage by Donnie of Daytona. And it says in the video, right at the beginning, she says, I'll have a link to Donnie's channel in the description. And when one clicks on that link, any guesses? Gone. So, yeah. He must have been talking about dangerous conspiracies or, you know, medical misinformation. What with a fucking camera pointed at the sky and all. I mean, there's 1,000,000,000 videos of UFOs and, you know, anomalous shit in the sky. But the one dude who caught 4 or 5 suns going by, his channel's gone. I'm just saying.
All right. Well, let's take a little break. We'll come back on the other side for the fourth and final of the IRONWORX. Right here, freeworld.fm. Josh, Walt, and Zack hanging out with you this morning. We are joined by Andrew and Travis. We'll be right back.
Lane in the Audubon, fast, like Ramadan. Had to battle young Padawans all the damn day. I'm getting naked and I'm popping on a ragga ball so hot I got the motherfucker a la flambe. I go to Miley's house, I see that Miley's home. I play Miley's rib cage with my dick like it's a xylophone. Yes, that was Miley fucked up, but my skills are highly honed. And if I was Miley hyphy, I might be more widely known. C'est la vie, better pay my fee. They kick it in Seattle in a Patagonia jacket, they get it in the bag in a plain white tee. Hey, mommy. Hey, mommy. Go P1T. Wanna see me speak? Then I go. Go, 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 go. Every time I get a beat, I know I gotta beat it up. I bend it, then I break it, then I chop it, then I eat it up. A pita would never approve it. The way I've been treating the music, I bleed it, I bruise it. I kick it to the curb, and then I'm sipping up my bourbon. I be freaking it, doing it, keeping it moving. I'm picking apart the muscle when I'm thinking about the hustle, but I'm nice. Nice! Freeway median, I'm savage. Cause my mode is that I'm meaner than the average. Like my teacher taught me when I heard the crowd applaud. I thought I was an atheist until I realized I'm a god. Think I heard a bit when I murder shit. In a moment I'll be tagging off a tourniquet. When I burn him and I hit him in the sternum, I don't even gotta enter, but I'm gonna win the tournament. That's what I'm all about. Do what I gotta do, and never gonna pout. And I hope that it would've been the end of it in a mouth, but they never tend to give me the benefit of the doubt. Ever since I was a little kid, I know that I've been looking for the hot spotlight. And if you really wonder what I think about the competition, they were not tight. I've been reading my scripture. Every photo bomber wanna be in my picture. And you bet I'm living every single day like it's the motherfucking Catalina wine mixer. Bada bang, bada boom. When I walk in, I'm the king of the room. And I get it locked in like a king in the tomb. When I spit a toxin and they cough on the fumes. Cause I'm back in the nick of time and attacking the fickle mind. I'm a jackal, the rip aside. I'm a tackle, the pick a fight. I be Dracula, set to fight in the black of the bitter night. And I'm out. Poof.
Hey! a goddamn lie.
Lady, 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 let me show you how it's supposed to be. Every lie you tell's another beat upon your rosary. Baby, 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 count your sins before you go to sleep. You may not be praying, but I know you've been down on your knees. Call me non-believer, you can call my ass a skeptic. Serving up some bullshit, man, I think I skipped that breakfast. I ain't even trying to bite, feeling anorexic. Leaving letters in the fire, take my shit and exit.
No, cause you's a goddamn lie. You must have lost your goddamn mind. No, cause you's a goddamn lie. You must have lost your goddamn, goddamn mind.
Something dumb. Tell me, does your new friend that you found like the sound of guns? Baby, 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 pull the hammer back with my thumb. Get this party started, everybody, are we having fun? Cold 45, you can drink from my revolver. This ain't holy water, this is dirty as a dollar. If I see the man, I might just let the musket holler. Broken man, woman, scorn, crying at the altar.
Cause you's a goddamn liar. You must have lost your goddamn mind. Ooh, cause you's a goddamn liar. You must have lost your goddamn, goddamn mind.
Underlay, move along, yeah, I'm on my way. And all of these troubles are just be bumps to my gondola. And I don't find problems with people, I just find love in my equals. Demons, they try slowing me down, these attempts are feeble. I got no reason for lying, I find no reason in treason. Fakers and followers, bitches, leaking like beacons. And yes, I know what they doing, yeah, I know what they trying. No, I don't waste my time, because I know that they lying.
Cause you's a goddamn liar. You must have lost your goddamn mind. Ooh, cause you's a goddamn liar. You must have lost your goddamn, goddamn mind.
And welcome back. Fourth and final segment of the IRONWORX kicking off right now. Good stuff. Good stuff.
I like that. Good stuff. Who was that?
That was Dirty Heads, I believe. Almost positive.
Turkey Head.
Dirty.
Oh.
Dirty Heads. Them Dirty Heads. They're one of them West Coast bands that like to spend their time skipping class and going to the beach. And you spend all day out in the ocean and you come in and you let your hair dry naturally. It's got all that salt kind of still hanging around up there in your hair, and eventually it starts to look a little dirty. So that's, they were the Dirty Headed Kids running around doing their thing.
Dirty Head.
Dirty Heads. Goddamn liar. Song before that was Watsky. Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's got a badass music video, the link for which I dropped into the chats. It's got a little guest appearance by Jim Belushi. At the very beginning. It's a really good video. As far as music videos go.
Belushi.
So I got a question for you guys and everyone else in chat. Two movies, and I haven't seen a good movie in a long time. Well, a new movie, at least. I haven't seen either one of these movies yet, so there's no spoilers. Just curious if anyone has seen the new King Kong movie, you know, King Kong and Godzilla movie, or the new Ghostbuster movie. I'm curious. They have pretty good reviews on it. I just haven't seen them, so I don't really know.
How new is the new King Kong Godzilla movie?
This week.
Yeah, there's a new one just hitting.
Oh. Haven't heard of it. Yeah, it's getting ready to watch the new Ghostbusters here soon.
Yeah, apparently, well, they're bringing back the original Ghostbusters, but there's like new Ghostbusters, not like the whole.
Yeah, the last movie had them with
Yeah, Ant-Man you didn't guy. See Ant. Yeah, Ant-Man. What's his name?
Paul Rudd.
Right. Who is as old now as fucking Wilford Brimley was when he did Cocoon. Put that in your head and think it through.
Oh my God, I haven't seen Cocoon in like 25 years.
Just think it through.
Just think it through.
Who is Steve Guttenberg, right? Cocoon?
Whatever happened to him? That was Guttenberg, yeah. That in the cop movies.
Police Academy.
3 men and a baby.
Wait, was that Sergeant Mahoney or whatever his name was?
Yeah. Mahoney.
Well, he sure wasn't Tackleberry.
Yeah, that's different.
Yeah, Tackleberry is my favorite, without a doubt.
Dude, I used to love watching Police Academy. Hey, so some good news. Walt, you sent me 5 images to have laser etched.
Oh yeah.
I sent him 4 of them, and he said he can absolutely do them. So,
really?
Yeah. That's so awesome, I sent him. So that's a total of like 9 I've already sent him. So I said, yeah, it's gonna keep him busy, and I already paid him for 3. So those are gonna be coming up for you guys. So I'll probably just have them sent to my house, and then from there, I'll need to find, or it doesn't really matter, I guess. We'll just have to find out a way to have them sent out. Yeah, there's going to be one for you, Josh, Zack, and Cami.
Oh, would it be easier to have him ship them from where he's at because he's set up to do it? I don't know. I'm just asking because I don't know the situation.
Right now.
Right. Yeah, we can figure it out for sure. Okay. Absolutely, man. You're awesome, brother.
It's on me. So, and I'll pay for all of it plus shipping and everything else.
Very cool, Andrew. Yeah,
that is.
Those things look awesome.
What the hell are we even talking about?
Just to let you know, my birthday is April 28th.
It'll be a surprise.
Well, I can send one to Travis as well. I'm going to send one to as many people as possible. Okay. Yeah, I'm not like a Rothschild or anything, but.
What's your family crest, Andrew?
Right, it'd be one thing to say I'm going to send one to as many people as I can afford to send one to. It'd be something completely different to say, well, I'm going to send one to anybody that possible. If it's possible that you could receive one, by God, I'm going to send you one. Anybody with an address, Andrew just said he's going to send you one. All it takes is an address.
As possible. until I run out of money. Please, yeah, those are going to be coming your way. It says that it takes him between 1 and 3 days to make one because he has to put it into like Adobe Illustrator or something like that and then work that out with the laser machine. And then, you know, has to layer all the glass and everything. And he also has artistic interpretation involved in it. So sometimes he may have to change the way the colors are a little tiny bit. But either way, my gift to you guys.
And see, I don't think I realized he could do colors. I thought it was like thing just because of how it was done. So that's why I was concerned with the ones that I gave you because of all the crazy different layering of colors and stuff. So, yeah.
Oh, no, that's not an issue. Cause,
oh, dude.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah.
Yeah. He stacks the, as far as I know, he stacks different layers of glass together, like multiple colors. And then the laser etches it down in a certain way so that it becomes multicolored. And he says that they're about 1/2 inch thick.
Cool.
which is, I thought, that's pretty thick for some glass, but yeah, when you stack multiple layers, that's what happens. But he said, yeah, those are pretty easy to do. But yeah, anyways, you'll see when you get it.
Cool. Awesome. And we'll definitely be plugging them and showing them off for sure.
Yeah, I'm going to be sending one off to Chris, you know, Flatman X. And, you know, because he's been doing all the promos for all the trivia. So he's going to be getting one of those. I'm not even sure if he's aware of it.
So. No, I just laughed because I see Michelle. Oh, God, Lord.
Oh, is he right there?
Talking about me. No. I see someone asking Josh a question in chat that made me laugh, and I did not realize I was not muted up. Sorry about that, Andrew.
Sorry. Oh, and by the way, Rico is the guy. I'm looking at chat now. Yeah, Rico is there in chat, and he's the one that connected me with Nick. That's the guy that is going to be doing all the laser etchings, and I'm going to probably purchase a bunch of those because Rico actually gave me the idea of getting a bunch of them made for the next Flattoberfest, which I'll probably end up maybe purchasing like 10 of them just to let Karen raffle them off with a FE map or whatever else. Anyone has any suggestions, or even just for Flattoberfest type of festival announcement.
Well, that sounds really cool.
Yes, he is talking about your friend, Rico.
Yes.
Josh, did you find the cable for your cricket machine?
Sorry, I didn't want to derail it too much there.
I did indeed.
Nice. Nice. Well, Liz was asking, oh, you gave her an answer. There we go. Shit, man, you're on top of things. Well, why don't you tell everybody else what's going on tonight on Have No Sphere, since we brought it up.
Yeah, well, I've seen a few crazy things regarding the pop eclipse and the eclipse and sort of the end of all time as it relates to what's coming here in just a few weeks, a couple weeks. But apparently there's a lot of people saying it's been prophesied at the end of the world. This is some sort of special eclipse for some reason, and everybody's out there pushing some weird, crazy fear porn of one flavor or another. And Brent,
well,
go ahead.
Well, no, go ahead. I'm just, again, not, yeah, go ahead.
I was just going to say that that's something that Brendan has seen and is chapping his ass a little bit, so to speak. So he's really going to love the chance to come on and try to debunk a lot of this weird fear porn that's being accompanied with this particular eclipse. I've not seen a whole lot of it and don't know any of the backstory, but I think it's going to be really exciting to get him back on. I know he's been doing some stuff. He's been raising money for some local shelters, just doing some really cool things.
Nice.
As Brendan does.
So I know he's a very active, yep, active guy. He don't just talk the talk. He fucking walks the walk. Well, we'll probably talk more about this later tonight, but just interesting that we spoke about it on last show on Wednesday, and then my son sent me a story and a text yesterday asking me had I seen this crazy shit, which was the story about the condition that makes people see demonic pointed ear, slit mouth, scarred faced demons instead of normal people all around them. And it's a condition, you see. And they're putting that fucking out into the world right now. I'm just saying. We'll talk about it tonight.
Really does make you wonder.
Do you have to wear special glasses?
Well, Roddy said
it. No, it's just...
Roddy said it was a fucking documentary.
He did. And then what happened to Roddy? Oh, that's right. He died. Coincidence, I'm sure.
Surely.
If you haven't read Twilight Eyes by Dean Koontz, go get your copy today. I'm just saying. Liz's time is about to get straight, finally. Well, what's that, brother?
Why is that? Can you describe the book?
Yeah, I mean, it's basically this idea of a gentleman who has this affliction, if you will, that since a child, his stepfather didn't look like a human being, and his stepfather abused him and his family, and he got away and realized that there were other people out in the world that didn't look like human beings. They looked like what he called goblins. And when he describes them, it's pretty much this idea of a demonic face. And these things are all amongst us and he can see them. And that's all I'm going to tell you, because it's a fucking great book that I don't want to spoil any of.
That's why I don't know what you're talking about.
He's another one of those. Along the Stephen King just makes you wonder, how in the fuck can you pump out books the way that you do? It's insane.
Dude, and not just the, like, he didn't just pump them out, hey, I'm Dean Koontz. Dude, he had like four or five pseudonyms that he was also pumping out books under as different genres, like science fiction or true crime or whatever. He's like, yeah, he diarrhea books, dude. He just, and what's nuts is it's always those books, or not always, but I would say 85% of the books I've read by him are filled with soul chill bumps that speak of a truth to me. He always has a lot to talk about animal relationships. Like, man, one of his best books, Watchers, has a dog in it that, yeah, it's, I'm not going to spoil it. Just fucking amazing about the relationship we have with our animals that are in our lives, our family, bird family. And then there was one book about the spiritual evolution, I guess, if you will, and these newer, younger, you know, I guess the children being born today that have these unusual insights at very advanced insights at a very young age, and the frequency that they are at, if you will, their vibrations quite a bit different than ours. There's a book, yeah. I'm trying to think of the title of it. Oh, man. I'll figure it out. I'll find it. I'm looking at the shelf right now at all the ones I can see, but I'd have to go dig to see the actual name. Anyway. Yeah, definitely one of those authors who speaks to truth. Yes, sir.
I was just thinking about your question about how did he crank out all of those novels, which is the same thing that I thought about with Stephen King, right? What if they were using AI this whole time and just having AI write their stuff?
Right. What if they have?
You know what I mean? Or like, they just rolled it out
for
the past 4 years, but they've been using it for all this time. And they, I mean, just imagine that. You could just really have your own AI. Like, if you wrote, you say, okay, write a story like Richard Bauckham, you know, AI would have no problem reading one story, getting his vibe, and then just being able to reduplicate everything that, you know, is his nuance, so it sounds like Richard Fox, sounds like Stephen King, sounds like Dean Koontz. I don't know.
Any technology that we're given, they've probably had for decades and is now obsolete to them. Just saying.
Well, like the technology that would be maybe Shakespeare. Right. If you have that corporate personhood, maybe you just create a corporation named Dean Koontz and you have an entire board that sits on this corporation called Dean Koontz, and every member of the board starts pumping out stories and books. Now you've got 12 people writing stories for this corporation called Dean Koontz, and you just put Dean Koontz on the title of all these stories, and wow, you can really diary out some stories if you've got 12 people writing for this one corporation called Dean Koontz. How's that for technology?
Already do that in a way. There's a lot of writers who will outsource chapters. And my mom's very good at knowing this because she knows her authors really well. The way they write, you know, the way they structure their sentences, just the little phrases they use. And she'll start reading a chapter and she'll get like two paragraphs in and be like, oh, this isn't a Grisham chapter. This is someone else. And then she'll skim through it, get the gist of what she needs to know from the chapter. They're usually not the important, like, plot twist chapters and things like that. They're filler chapters. But yeah, they've been doing this for a very long time. But yeah, I wouldn't doubt that there's a bunch of people sitting around pretending like they're all one person. I wouldn't doubt that at all.
I just like the idea of a board of directors on a corporation, because then you're all contributing. You've got that motivation to want to continue to pump out stories under a pseudonym and do it as a collective. And that revenue just rolls in, especially if you can do it under different names and different genres.
Oh, yeah.
I finally remember the name of it. It's called From the Corner of His Eye by Dean Koontz. Yeah, if you haven't checked it out, definitely do so.
From the corner of his eye.
Yeah. We're rounded down to the last 3 minutes here, Jim.
Yeah, we did it. And it was pretty fun. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Andrew. Thank you, Travis.
Cheers, gents.
Happy Friday,
always my friend.
Happy Friday, my friend.
Josh, you can't start no shit now, are you?
Happy Friday, my friend.
Happy Friday, my friend.
Yeah, hi. Hey. This is Josh, and I was wondering if I could get an energy reading.
Absolutely. Josh?
Yeah.
You ain't gonna start no shit, is you?
Say what?
You ain't gonna start no shit, is you?
No, no.
Uh-huh. You sure?
I'm sure.
Uh-huh. Josh? Uh-huh. Yeah. Are you there?
I am here.
Hold on. Give me a second here. Oh, my goodness. Run low on time. Hold on here. My goodness. You know, sometimes when you talk to my children... get off of here!
What is happening?
Do you have battle codes, Andrew?
Peepers! Yeah, I ain't got time for this. I'm starting off.
Let me know what that is.
Starting off.
All right, guys.
I look good. Feel good. I am good. That was great.
All right, guys. Well, we love you very much. Thanks for hanging out this morning.
Come hang out this evening. Brendan Daly. Heck yeah.
And Andrew, I can't believe you don't know who Flaccid Ego is.
I don't know. Sorry.
I'll tell you
I'm
what.
I'm disappointing you.
Before you fall asleep tonight, roll on over to YouTube and search Flaccid Ego. You'll know it when you find it.
Will I be disappointed?
No. Oh, you won't be disappointed at all.
Okay. You'll imagine. I'll do it right now, then.
Wait till the end of the show, dickhead. You still got a minute.
You still got a minute.
Hold on. Okay. You too.
Well, we love you guys. Thanks for hanging out this morning. We will see you back here, if not this evening, as we hang out with our good buddy Brendan Daly. Then we will see you back here next week, Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, 4 a.m. Central to 6 a.m. We sure love you guys. Be good. Be well. Have a great weekend. Do good and do well. We love you. Bye.